Right now, a lab worker from the CDC is being monitored for Ebola symptoms after a possible exposure. Officials are trying to figure out how the mistake happened, but believe the employee accidentally transferred live samples of the virus into the wrong lab on Monday. The mix-up was reported to authorities on Tuesday. Now about a dozen other employees who worked in the lab are also being assessed. Now, if this sounds familiar, that's because it's not the first time a mistake like this has happened. Last summer, nearly 100 CDC workers were potentially exposed to anthrax after employees failed to inactivate the bacteria before transferring it to a lab. And last spring, CDC workers in Atlanta sent a sample contaminated with the deadly bird flu to a lab about 60 miles away. So let's talk more about this with Dr. Devi. She's an assistant professor at NYU's School of Medicine. Good morning to you, Dr. Devi. So what's your reaction first to this latest mistake?
Well, I mean, it's concerning on a couple of different levels. For the CDC itself, like you mentioned, there have been a couple errors in the past already this year, and it doesn't look good to have this happen, especially after the congressional hearing in July, where they said they were going to revamp their safety protocols. I mean, it's possible that because it's the holidays, that they were short-staffed and they weren't able to follow all of those. But in that case, you know, they have to be particularly careful and at least halt the work. Now, in terms of larger context, I think the thing is, you know, we always get concerned about healthcare workers, you know, their risk of developing Ebola or getting exposed to Ebola. So in this case, now, you know, scientists, research scientists may also become more concerned about their risk. And, you know, we don't want people to get dissuaded from potentially doing research on this deadly disease.
Right. But when you talk about the risk, I mean, we know the scientists who transferred the sample, that scientist is at risk. Maybe about a dozen workers or so who had contact with the lab now being looked at. I mean, how big is the risk, I guess, for these employees?
I think the risk is still relatively low, because if you think about the healthcare workers who developed Ebola here, I mean, they were treating patients with Ebola. They basically were exposed to vomit, diarrhea, blood. You know, they're getting exposed to a lot of different bodily fluids. So the way that you get Ebola is from bodily fluid to bodily fluid. In this case, you know, there are no bodily fluids. The virus is right there. But the thing is, you know, the technicians, the scientists are not actually trying to they're keeping it contained in a vial or maybe looking at it under a microscope. They're not necessarily trying to treat someone. So they might be still much more cautious than a healthcare worker who's rushing to the aid of someone else who's sick.
You know, we talked about the similar cases, you know, where others have been exposed. And the CDC is now saying that there's no risk to the public. But as we were saying, this is one of several mistakes that we've heard about recently. So how much should we trust, do you think, at this point, what the CDC is telling us? I mean, about not to worry.
Exactly. I mean, it's a difficult situation because, of course, anytime there's an exposure, there's a potential risk. I mean, to those employees and then to the people that they come in contact with. So, you know, there is something. I wouldn't say there's no risk. But at the same time, we don't want to create a panic because the fact is, you know, they seem to be relatively on top of this, at least compared to earlier this year. I mean, the concern is more, if you think about it, in terms of the U.S., you know, do we have to worry as much right now? Maybe not. But in terms of West Africa, I mean, those cases, the numbers are raging still. You know, there are 20,000 cases almost, about 8,000 deaths are approaching that amount. So, you know, in terms of the danger of Ebola or the general risk or our concern, our level should be a little bit higher than it is right now, but maybe not at the level of fear that we had a few months ago.
So is there any way then to eliminate this human error, or is it really just inevitable in this world?
Well, human error is inevitable. Everybody is going to make mistakes no matter what, but we know about it. So it's not an unexpected mistake. We know people make mistakes. So, for example, in the hospital, we have different checklists, like in the OR. You know, when people travel on a plane, pilots have different checklists that they follow, too, to minimize that error. They have one person doing something. They have other people on their team checking them. So there's always checks and balances. In this case, I'm not sure why those processes, I mean, they say they're in place, but there seem to be a lot of slip-ups in those areas. But, you know, human error, again, it's inevitable, but you can do things to minimize that and minimize that harm, especially if you're dealing with deadly viruses.
Absolutely. Dr. Devi, appreciate your expertise. Thank you very much.
Thank you.